According to a new report by The Intercept, 4 undercover FBI agents posing as ISIS members convinced an autistic teenager to attempt to join ISIS and then arrested him on terrorism charges shortly after his 18th birthday. So for 2 years, they're basically priming this kid, okay, the 16-year-old, and trying to convince him to try to join ISIS. And I think that's entrapment. I don't know, I'm not a legal expert, but let me give you the details. So Humzah Mashkoor first came onto the authorities' radar because of social media posts around the time of his 16th birthday. So he was allegedly posting in support of terrorism in November of 2021. And a platform that he was posting on had alerted the FBI of suspicious activity, which is great. I mean, I think that they should do that. You want to make sure that you're crossing your T's, dotting your I's if you're seeing someone promote terrorism and terroristic threats. But unfortunately, the FBI appears to have used that as an opportunity to entrap someone, because then in July of 2022, police were called to his home after he allegedly assaulted a family member. It was at this time that a relative told police about Mashkoor's autism and mental illness. So they were aware of that. Then 2 months later, FBI agents posing as members of ISIS started communicating with him, and they started stringing him along until he became an adult, a legal adult who could get arrested as an adult for attempting to engage in terrorism or provide support to terrorism. With their encouragement, Mashkoor developed a plan to support the terror group, along with extensive discussions of what type of services he might provide ISIS. He regularly confided in the agents about his boredom, family problems, hopes of getting married, and struggles with his mental health. So he's sharing these details with them. And the FBI agents are like, oh, you've got mental health issues? So what? We're gonna entrap you. At one point, he told an agent that he was considering finding a wife who'd be willing to join him in Afghanistan, but he worried about the possibility of abandoning her if he ends up getting killed. And throughout the chats, he expressed support for ISIS and fantasized about fighting with militants, but he also went back and forth about whether he wanted to join the group. In one message, he worried that the brothers there might not support me in getting married and may just strap something on me and throw me out into the field. He may, he suggested at one point, instead get a job and finish school, right? He's a teenager, he's an idiot. Like, not all teenagers are idiots, but a lot of idiots are teenagers, okay? And so like he has these like romanticized ideas of what ISIS is, and at the same time, he's got full-blown adults, you know, putting ideas in his head. And he constantly referred to himself as a minor in these exchanges, but the agents continued to prod him. They never reached out to his parents or family members and instead helped him concoct plans to travel to Afghanistan in an effort to join ISIS. My family know I'm leaving, but don't know why, and they're very sad, and it's been having a toll on my mental health, he said. I don't know how to properly say my final goodbyes to them, or how to convey the reasons why I left without compromising myself. Then on December 18th, weeks after he turned 18 years old, he unfortunately followed through with the plans that he was goaded into doing. He was at the Denver airport getting ready to board a plane to Dubai when FBI agents showed up and arrested him on terrorism charges. And as a result of his conversations with the FBI, he could face a 20-year prison sentence. So he hasn't stood trial for this, and it's for attempting to provide material support to a terrorist organization. This reminds me of a little of the FBI activity that took place among like the white, you know, the people who are gonna go after the governor of Michigan. There was a little bit of entrapment in that case as well, Rayyvana, and you're more of a legal expert than I am. So what do you think about this?
Well, I mean, I think that it is certainly entrapment, but it's a tactic that the FBI has been using for decades now, particularly, you know, a surgence of it post 9/11 in this country, and particularly preying on people with intellectual disabilities as their targets. But I want to remind everybody that the school shooting in Iowa that happened just a week ago, the shooter was on Discord in a group that had been reported to the FBI planning out his mass shooting in that school. The FBI responded to that message they received. They were aware of that group and his activities in it. Did they prevent him from carrying out a mass shooting? No, they didn't. Because let's face it, a Middle Eastern sounding name sounds better on a press release from the FBI than the name of a white kid from Middle America. But just to that point, I mean, it's despicable that this is hundreds of cases of this, if not thousands of cases of this, have happened over the years. Mm-hmm. And that many of these people don't ever see justice for this, for what's happened to them. In fact, they spend the rest of their life behind jail for a crime that was committed against them.
Hey, thanks for watching the video. We really appreciate it, guys. And we appreciate it if you become members, because that allows us to be independent, honest, progressive, all the things that you don't get from corporate media. And all of that is because of you guys. Hit the join button below and become one of us, become a Young Turk.